I got my first real six string, bought it at the five and dime. Played it till my fingers bled. Was the summer of 69. Me and some cats from school had a band and we tried real hard. Jimmy quit, Jody got married. Should've known that we'd never get far. Oh, when I look back now, it's summer seemed to last forever. And if I had that choice, yeah, I wanna always be there. Those were the best days of my life. Ain't no use in complaining when you've got a job to do. Spend my engines down after driving, and that's when I met you. Standing on your mother's porch, you told me that you wait forever. Now I knew of my hand, I knew that it was now or never. Those were the best days of my life. Oh yeah, back in the summer of 69. Look at everything that's come and gone. And when I play that old 16, I think about you when the world went wrong. Standing on your mother's porch, you told me that you wait forever. Oh, when you held my hand, I knew that it was now or never. Those were the best days of my life.
Hi, my name is Izzy Goffman. I'm a sophomore and I've been in the dance program for 2 years.
And I'm a junior and I've been in the dance department for, this will be my third year.
Hi, my name's Hannah. I'm a junior at JSerra and I've been in the dance program for around 3 years.
When I think of the dance department at JSerra, what comes to mind first is just the community that we've built and the great friends that I've made and all of the experimentation that I get to do with my art that I love, which is like a really good place to do that and build that here at JSerra.
Mainly, Ms. McCullen is very creative, and
when I think of the dance department at JSerra, I feel like we have a really great family feel and we're all so close with each other and we love Ms. McCullen and it's just a great family.
My favorite part of the dance program at JSerra is just this amazing community that we've built of girls who are so supportive of each other, and I can do anything and experiment any way I want with my art because they're all just so supportive of me, and I know that anything I do, they'll love, and that is just so warming for me and being able to come here and do the thing I love every day.
Only the friendships and like us being sisters, because we always have each other's backs.
I love how we are all able to create our own things in the dance department.
The curriculum at JSerra inside the dance room helps me with my life outside the dance room, because this program just really pushes you to do your best and try new things and be as creative as you possibly can.
Dance has kind of taught me more styles in dance, and in the classroom it's taught me to be more hardworking and how to have a better ethic about what I do.
The JSerra dance program affects my life outside of JSerra, by bringing creativity into my life.
A few words that stand out to me when thinking of the program as a whole would probably be one, creativity, family, positivity, love, and inspiration.
I think the program is definitely a supportive community, and we all just love each other and we want to support each other.
Love, community, family, creativity, and art are all words that come to me about the JSerra Dance Program.
All right, let's see what we can do.
Rolling. Take one. Rolling.
All right, let's do it. Here we go. Back to the beginning. Stand by. Recording.
Drawing and painting is very therapeutic for me. It's almost like it's so peaceful. It's kind of like drowns out everything else. And when I'm painting, it's just like nothing else kind of matters, which helps a lot when you're, you know, in high school and you have like a lot of work to do. The artist that inspires me most is probably my like second cousins. They are both artists and they just have been doing it for so long, and they just like, they're so amazing at it. I love both of them. The person, like the people that have been most supportive would probably be my parents. They're always like really supportive with my art. And yeah, I definitely like, I don't know if I want to have a career with it. Like, at least not yet. I don't know what I want to do with my life. I'm only a sophomore, but like, it'll always be something that I'll do. Just whether or not I use it as a career, I don't know yet.
We'll be right back. we kind of recently been kind of taking songs and putting them, put our own spin on it. So like, take a song and then splash a little Green Day on it and then the Replacements. So we do basically. True care,
truth brings, I'll take. Before each football game we perform, and like whenever we get the chance, whenever the school allows us to perform, like at open house and stuff, and just anything we can possibly do.
I think it's giving us pretty good exposure to figure out how to work with a crowd and audience, and how to communicate and like not just be like playing songs and just being really lifeless.
It's a lot of fun here to perform. It's so fun. It just like takes away everything that's going on in your life. Mr. Phillips is a great teacher. He's super laid back, really fun. He's always down to help us out with anything. Doesn't matter what it is. He basically has like created this environment for us where we can like come here and like just be ourselves and just have fun and just play music.
A lot of other teachers, especially for music, they want to take control of what we're doing. They want to be able to be in full control, full scheduling, full songs. They want to choose everything. They want to write parts for everybody. But Mr. Amrine recognizes that we have our own individual talents.
I think I have grown a lot through this rock band specifically, like learning how to be a good person and like work together with people, even though sometimes it's like everyone's just fighting over stuff. Like you gotta like work it out, because without each other, like we wouldn't be able to play our music.
Having the rock band here does certainly help my academics, because I use it as kind of like a stress reliever in a way to just get out of my mind. Obviously, I am a little tired every day because it's a zero period, but I think it's worth it because I love how much this band just brings all of us together.
Playing an instrument, it's a little different. You have to express yourself. Each person has their own role, and you can express yourself through that role, and it's really cool how you can just release those anxieties and just kind of let out that inner scream without, like, flipping in the middle of class or something, you know?
If I have any frustrations or anything, I don't get to bring it to my academic classes. I don't get to let it affect me. In that sense, I get to bring it here. I get to deal with it how I want to deal with it. And it gets me prepared for the rest of the day really well. And at the end of the day, I look forward to coming back in here after school and still playing music.
September ends, like my father's come to pass. 7 years has gone so fast. Wake me up when September ends. Here comes the rain again, falling from the stars. Drenched in my pain again, becoming who we are. As my memory rests, but never forgets what I lost. Wake me up when September ends. Yeah. temper ends. Summer has come and passed, the innocent can never last. Wake me up when September ends. Like my father's come to pass, 20 years has gone so fast. Wake me up when September.
Valentino Osorio, and I'm president of the JSerra Choir. So I wanted to talk to you a little bit about what choir is all about. We are just one huge family, and we love getting together during class time and after school hours to create harmonies together. And we go on many different trips. We've gone to Italy, Nashville, Spain, and many different places. And it's just such a family and a wonderful family to be a part of. So here at JSerra, we actually have four different choirs. The first one is the beginning men's choir, and they always have a blast. There's a whole bunch of the freshman football players there and many other boys who just love getting together and singing for fun. And then so our next choir is the Advanced Women's Ensemble, which is a group of women, and they come together and sing as a family. And then there's chorale, which is a bigger chorus of both men and women of about more than 30 kids who get together during the school day and rehearse. Next we have jams, which is the JSerra Arts Magnet Singers, and they rehearse after school for 3 hours, and they do mostly a cappella music. I'm so happy that I joined choir my freshman year because it's something that will just follow me for my entire life, and I would love to continue it in college and meet even more people by making harmonies in choir. So, enjoy our performance!
Thank you. so it is. Just like you said it would be. Life goes easy on me. Most of the time. And so it is. The shorter story. Take my eyes off of you. I can't take my eyes off of you. I can't take my eyes off of you. I can't take my it should be. We'll both forget the breeze. Most of the time. So it is. Take my eyes off of you. I can't take my eyes off of you. Can't take my eyes. Take my mind off of you. Can't take my.
Hi, my name is Ashley Mello. I'm a sophomore at JSerra Catholic High School, and this is my second year within the film program. When I first came here in film one, I definitely had the idea that I wanted to do something in like fantasy, sci-fi type of stuff, filmmaking, but here in film two is when I really started realizing that my passion is actually doing serious or dramatic film. We take all those skills we learned the previous year in film one, and here we develop them, and we each kind of have, with each project that we do here, with whether it's like camera techniques or advanced editing, here we're definitely growing and on all of our skills as filmmakers in training, as film students. When you have an idea in your head and you storyboard it, you write the script, you get all the dialogue and everything, and then you shoot it, and then you edit it, and in the end, the most like amazing thing is like every single thing you pictured in your head, like seeing it on a single timeline, like seeing it all done. It for me, the first time, like, it was mind-blowing just seeing how your ideas, just images that were in your head, now they're literally right in front of you, like everything's done. And so I have no idea what we're gonna do in film three, but I definitely know it's gonna be even more developed and a lot more advanced than it has been in these previous 2 years. And so I think that here I've definitely learned a lot that I wouldn't have in other schools. Like here I've been able to develop my techniques, my filmmaking, like everything here. So I would definitely say if you want to pursue filmmaking, like you need to have that passion, because it's not easy. No career is easy, and definitely for film, if you really want to pursue it, you have to put in the effort, you have to do so many things, but it'll be definitely worth it. Thank you.
You think I'm an ignorant savage, and you've been so many places, I guess it must be so, but still I cannot see if the savage one is me. How can there be so much that you don't know? You don't know. You think you own whatever land you land on. The earth is just a dead thing you can claim. But I know every rock and tree and creature has a life, has a spirit, has a name. You think the only people who are people are the people who look and think like you. But if you walk the footsteps of a stranger, you'll learn things you never knew, you never knew. Have you ever
under a bushel,
it's like something kind of crucial.
You've got to stay bright to be the light of the world.
You are the salt of the earth.
You are the salt of the earth.
his favor. It ain't got much in his favor.
You can't have that fault and be the salt of the earth. So let your light so shine, people, yeah. Let your light so shine, so that they might know some kindness again. We all need help to feel fine.
But us the one.
Woo!
It's got a hard eyed world.
You gotta stay pretty in the city of God. So let your light so shine, people, man. Let your light so shine, so that they might know some kindness again. We all need help to feel fine.
Let's have some wine. You are the light of the world.
Someday you'll die. Hi, I'm Grace Puglisi, and today I had the chance to interview the Orchestra Magnet Program.
My name is Alex Lopez, and I play the cello.
Hi, I'm Abigail Cox, and I play the flute and piccolo.
I think the Magnet Program is special because it's just a really fun working environment, and people like me get a lot more out of orchestral music.
I definitely was nervous when I was joining the Magnet Program because I felt like I wasn't like that talented enough to be in it, which is completely false. Like, everyone is, no matter your musicality level, Mr. Amrine and Mr. Neely will help you grow it to a much higher level than you ever expected it to be.
One of my favorite songs that I played recently with my orchestra is this song called Danzone No. 2. And it's my favorite song because the rest of the orchestra, it was their favorite song too. And it really brought us closer together in a way that no other song has before.
My favorite song to play with the orchestra is Danzone No. 2 because it's such a fun Spanish piece that we all love to play so much. It's the longest piece we've ever played, and we just performed it at a fall concert, and it was such a success. About Mr. Amrine is that he cares about us so much. It's crazy. Like, I know that all of our teachers at JSerra really care, but like he's always there, and he's always here to help us with whatever we need, even if it's not with orchestra, and it's just, you need to talk, like he's always there.
Morning. Today's forecast calls for blue skies.
My name is Nelson Wilkins. I'm a photography student at JSerra, and I'm a junior. Through photography, I can express my creativity by taking pictures of whatever I want and adding my own unique personal touches to it through Photoshop or going to unique places that I like. Photoshop is very complicated, and there's a lot of unique features that take a while to learn, but once you learn it all, then you can become pretty good at it. JSerra has inspired me to pursue photography further. I really enjoy photography, and I like to keep doing it for the rest of my life, whether it be professionally or just for fun. Mr. Chaska is a very good teacher, and he's very knowledgeable about cameras, Photoshop, and composition of photos, and he guides us along in all of our projects and gives us good ideas for projects so we can always know what we can do.
My name's Cammie. I'm a photography student at JSerra, and I'm a junior. I can express my creativity through photography by just being myself and putting my mind to whatever I want and letting my creativity take toll. JSerra has inspired me to pursue this career in my life, and I want to use it more throughout my life, not just in high school. I might be able to do things with it later in life. So, Mr. Chesko has inspired me to be a better student with photography. He's taught me so many things that I never knew about. He is very knowledgeable, obviously, and I can't wait to use his teachings throughout my life. My favorite part about photography is definitely editing. Having my friends in my class, it's really fun with them. They inspire me to create these wonderful photos, and I can express my creativity.
My name is Natalie Abel. I'm a junior, and I'm in graphic design too. Graphic design allows me to express my creativity, mainly through like the different types of like projects we do. There's like a different variety. Like my teacher, he gives me like, we did one for like a winter showcase. We did like optical illusion. Like it's just like a bunch of different like types of projects we get to do. And there's really like no restriction on like what you can and cannot do. It's mostly just like you have to follow the guidelines of the project, but like you're really like allowed to like just like take like your creativity and just like do whatever you want with it, just like experiment with the program and just like make it like really fun. This is an area I'd like to pursue further in life. I'm like really into like computer graphics. Mr. Cal motivates me to follow my passion, mainly because he's like really passionate about the graphic design itself. And you know, whenever I need help or advice, he's like always there for me. He has really good like taste in like how to like present a piece and like create a piece, and he's like just really good at what he does. And he's just like a really outgoing person. He just makes the class like really fun.
Thank you.
everyone. I'm Jillian Shade, and I've been a part of the Line Report for now 3 years since my freshman year, and I've truly been able to watch it grow and just be able to experience all the amazing aspects of broadcast journalism. The Line Report is totally like a family. I mean, the environment when we all come in, bouncing ideas off each other, that's how it's gonna be when we go into the real workplace. And so it's really cool to be able to work as a community and incorporate JSerra students and teachers into our segments. Our shows are 4 days a week and they're all live. So we usually have segments all produced by the students, and everyone comes here during the break. We gather around, we have people, two hosts usually, and then a director, we have audio, teleprompter, technical director, so many different options, but it airs live on all the TVs at JSerra. I love all the different aspects. I originally started out just wanting to be in front of the camera, but through Line Report have just been able to develop a love for audio and for directing and behind the scenes TriCasters and editing. And I've also learned about like filming on DSLR cameras, which I never thought would happen. But I just love Line Report in general, and I want to hopefully do it in the future. There are so many different things that Line Report like fosters in us, and I think one of that is work ethic. I mean, we have to get segments done every 2 weeks, so it keeps us on our toes. And I've also learned just so many different things, like how to operate with other people, how to work in a group, and you know, how to keep up with deadlines. So with the Arts Magnet, we're able to go on these like really cool field trips, like ESPN News and like MBS Studios and all these different really amazing places. And we're able to like talk with people in the industry, see how they got to where they are and just like how it operates. And oftentimes us Arts Magnet students are just like amazed at how similar our program is to like theirs, obviously on a smaller scale, but just how like prepared we are to be able to go into the workplace. I'm so excited to see where Line Report takes me and my fellow classmates. And I know as a freshman, I've looked up to all the past Line Reports and just I've seen the program grow. And so I'm excited when I leave and go to college and hopefully get a job at a new station that I'll be able to look back at the Line Report and just be able to see all the marks that all my fellow classmates and I have made on the Line Report. And I want to give a special thanks to Ms. Breckbell and Mr. Sulaka, who have just constantly been giving all their love and support to us and helping us grow in our future careers. I'm Jillian, and this is The Line Report.
For love. Hi, my name is Lexi Schmidt. I'm a transfer sophomore, and this is my first year at JSerra. I'm a member of the Arts Magnet. The best part about the Magnet is probably the ensemble work, learning to work as a team, because a lot of people think acting is more of a one-on-one thing. You get on stage and shine, but really it's a collaborative piece, building a project that you're proud of. In the future, I definitely want to pursue something in the arts, primarily singing, more commercial music. That's where what I want to go to school for, commercial music, music management, yeah. My biggest role model for singing would definitely be Alicia Keys, because she not only thrives with singing and she is amazing in that regard, but also when it comes to her piano playing and her performance level. I've done about 11 performances in my life for shows, acting. Singing, it would be way more than that, probably triple that. But my favorite one was probably the most recent one that we did at JSerra, which was Godspell. I played the role of Celise. Being in the theater program, I hope to increase my acting skills, because primarily I focused a lot on singing and then I did dance for 9 years, and so I want those to rise about the same levels. The most recent show I did was Godspell, JSerra. Like I said, I was Celise. Also right now, we just had opening night for Alice in Wonderland. I'm crewing that, so I'm not actually on stage, but I'm working backstage, which is also a really important part of the show. I'd like to give a special thanks to everybody in the theater class for showing me how to work as an ensemble rather than just a solo, and also to Mr. Riggs, the theater teacher, really helping me grow and thrive and helping build up my acting skills so they're up where singing and dancing would be.
Hello. My name is Mr. David Amrine, and I am the Performing Arts Department Chair here at JSerra Catholic High School. And on behalf of all of my colleagues and the hundreds of students whose work you witnessed tonight, I wanted to thank you for coming tonight before our finale. Now, we've had a journey through all four seasons this evening in sort of a quick amount of time. And we've ended prematurely with spring, because we are still in actual winter, of course. It is February 21st today. We're exactly 1 month from the first day of spring. And spring at JSerra, amongst other things, certainly means spring musical. It's an annual tradition that we've been doing for many, many years at the school. And very shortly after March 21st is April 1st, which is the opening day. This is not an April Fool's joke. This is very, very soon. It's not a joke. Is the opening day of our very ambitious, very collaborative musical this year, The Hunchback of Notre Dame. And we are so very excited to preview four selections from that show for you here tonight. And we hope that this may entice you to come from one very collaborative arts production tonight to another very collaborative arts production in about 6 weeks' time. So, thank you for coming tonight, and enjoy the finale of our program.
Gather here today under this vast symphony of stone,
on the morning of the Feast of Fools. Our streets will soon be filled with those unsavory elements. Criminals, foreigners, and gypsies, who are on this one day free to roam without being subject to arrest. Beware the temptations less devout than we. Do not indulge yourselves, for remember, we are all born sinners.
My sanctuary. Safe behind these windows and these parapets of stone, gazing at the people down below me. All my life I watch them as I hide here alone, hungry for the histories they show me. All my life I memorize their faces, knowing them as they will never know me. All my life I wonder how it feels to pass a day out above them, but part of them, and out there living in the sun. Give me one day out there, all I ask is one to hold forever out there, where they all live unaware. What I'd give, what I'd tear, just to live one day out there. I can see them. Every day they shout and scold and go about their lives. Heedless of the gift it is to be them. If I were in their skin, I'd treasure every instant out there, strolling by the scent. Taste a morning out there, like ordinary men who freely walk about there, just one day, and then I swear I'll be content with my share. Won't resent, won't despair, oh, that's bent. I won't care, I'll outspend one day out there.
To treat you, could you not treat them?
Our Lord Jesus himself said something very similar. Do you see him there on the cross gazing down on us? Midday Mass is starting. My child, though your people are lost, you could still be saved. Stay and perhaps you can find out what true beauty is, and we can continue this conversation later.
Gypsy's prayer. Yes, I know I'm just an outcast. the mercy they don't find on earth. God help my people, they look to you still. God help the outcasts, or nobody will.
Thank you.
Thank you once again for coming this evening. We know we'll see you April 1st, 2nd, 3rd, or 4th for the full show on our quad at JSerra. Drive safe, folks.